Dear children, so what we have discussed so far, we have learned about life processes, different life processes and nutrition, the first life process in which two types, autotrophic and heterotrophic, this what we have completed in two different classes. Now we shall move to the second important life process, that is respiration. Respiration means exchange of gases. Oxygen and carbon dioxide are two important gases which are exchanged between which are exchanged through this process. Okay, so especially if you take in plants, mostly when production of food is taking place, plants, what they do, they take in carbon dioxide and release out oxygen. But in animals, we take in oxygen and we release out carbon dioxide. That is what mostly taking place here. What for this oxygen is essential? This oxygen is very much essential for utilizing food for release of energy, to release the energy. So energy means what, whether it has any name? Yeah. So the energies are nothing but stored in the form of biochemical compounds. So these biochemical compounds are called ATPs. So ATPs means what? Adenosine triphosphates. And these adenosine triphosphates are nicknamed as energy currencies of cell. Of course, this about these all we have learned in class 9 itself. It's just a reminder to all of you. And then these ATPs are produced and stored in mitochondria. Okay. So now we shall proceed into the process of respiration. So the process of respiration basically of two types, one is anaerobic respiration, another one is aerobic respiration. It is based on availability of oxygen. So if there is presence of oxygen, that respiration is aerobic respiration. If the respiration taking place in the absence of oxygen, we call it as anaerobic respiration. Okay, that is a basic difference between these two different types. In anaerobic respiration, absence of oxygen is there, means oxygen is not utilized at all. But in aerobic respiration, of course, what we do normally is presence of oxygen, right? Now the types of respiration, aerobic, anaerobic, how does it take place? With the help of this simple flow chart, we can understand it better. So glucose is the food produced in photosynthesis, we have seen, and that is converted into pyruvic acid. In our body, it takes place when the food is digested. No, the food gets firstly converted into pyruvic acid. Pyruvic acid is also called pyruvate. Here is mentioned pyruvate. Okay, so that pyruvate, when it is digested in the absence of oxygen, what happens? You see, especially in yeast, when it is digested in the absence of oxygen in yeast, there is produced ethanol, carbon dioxide, and release of energy taking place there. At the same time, it is absence of energy, okay, and at the same time, the organism which can take oxygen for digestion of food but unable to take, or lack of oxygen condition is there, that time what happens, especially in our muscles, because all the muscle cells are not 100% supplied with the oxygen. If suppose we have some problems in circulatory system, or we have some problem in our blood count and etc., wherein this problem comes, okay. So in muscle cells, what is happening here, in the absence of oxygen, in the lack of oxygen, what happened, that pyruvic acid is converted into lactic acid. It's an acid, okay, lactic acid. At the same time, energy is released, but this lactic acid is kept stored in muscles. If the lactic acid is kept accumulated and then stored in muscles, what happens, they will go for keeping on corroding our muscle cells. It's natural. Acid will go and deteriorate the muscles, and then whatever, wherever it falls, right? If suppose hydrochloric acid is fallen into our hand, immediately wound is created. No, it's all because of the deteriorative nature, corrosive nature of the acid. Similarly, lactic acid also become corrosive there and then goes for damaging the muscle cells. That is why some people have knee problem and then ankle some issues, some pain there in the joints, joint pain and all, maybe because of this lack of oxygen. Okay, so that gets converted into lactic acid, and lactic acid start accumulating, which start damaging and corroding our muscles also, especially in joints. This is happening, and some diseases are also caused by like that. So you might have had uric acid issue, and you might have had arthritis. Okay, so these are the best examples wherein the acids play different role, the villain role in our body, and one among them is this. So lack of oxygen causes formation of lactic acid, which causes damages our muscles. Then another one, normal glucose is converted into pyruvate is in the presence of oxygen, is well digested. That is happening in the mitochondria, we have already seen that in mitochondria. By the time carbon dioxide is released, we are releasing out. Water is formed, we are releasing out. Water vapor is formed. You take how to identify we are releasing out carbon dioxide as well as water vapor. Very simple. You take a mirror, keep there. When you breathe out, you just see. And breathe in directly, breathe out directly there, and you can find in the mirror some foggy structure, and that foggy is nothing but what? Water vapor. Okay, carbon dioxide will not freeze like that, but water vapor, water which comes from our body in the form of vapor which comes out, and then later when it gets in contact with atmospheric temperature, it gets cooled down. That's why that foggy structure comes. Okay, this is the simple way we can understand water vapor is also released out when we respire out. Carbon dioxide is released out, water vapor is released out, and energy, of course, that is meant for respiration, is meant for release of energy. That energy in the form of ATP kept stored in our mitochondria. So this process takes place in mitochondria. It's a very important flowchart. Now, the differences between aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration, it's for exam point of view as well as your entrance point of view, we will discuss. Basically, aerobic respiration takes place in the presence of oxygen. Anaerobic respiration takes place in the absence of oxygen. And aerobic respiration takes place in mitochondria. Anaerobic respiration doesn't take place in mitochondria, takes place only in cytoplasm of the cell. And then aerobic respiration generally goes for releasing of carbon dioxide and water in the form of water vapor as products. But here anaerobic respiration goes for producing acid, lactic acid, as well as alcohol. Both are dangerous for health. And high amount of energy is released in aerobic respiration. Very low amount of energy is released by anaerobic respiration. And already we have seen the examples for aerobic anaerobic organisms. Fungi, animals, plants are best example for aerobic respiration. And the anaerobic respiration examples are certain bacteria and yeasts. They perform anaerobic respiration. Now, respiratory system. This is what respiration in human beings. We have a confirmed, very, very well knit and then well formed respiratory system in our body, like a digestive system. Here respiratory system is also very, very important and simple. Just you see nostrils, through which only we respire in, respire out, right? So that inspiration means inhalation of oxygen, which takes place through nostrils, and that nasal passage comes and gets connected here. And this part is called larynx, okay? This part is called larynx, and it gets, comes and then connects. And here one box type is there, that is called pharynx, okay? So larynx is this portion and pharynx is one box type here. So the when we inhale the air, which comes from the nostrils to the pharynx, the box, and then from back the pharynx it comes to the larynx, and it is all transported. I am being reminded by my mobile to go for having a water. Okay, fine. Now, so this larynx, and then from the larynx it goes down to this trachea. You just touch and see this one, it's soft. At the same time there are small tubes joined together along a hose pipe type. No, the Vodafone we say, no, hose pipe. So the hose pipe type, here it is there, and that is called a trachea. And that trachea gets divided into two, and then it gets into the large structures which are there in the thoracic cavity. This is thoracic cavity. Here only the lungs are present. So the lungs here are connected with the trachea by means of the divided trachea. Here the divided trachea are called bronchi, singular bronchus and plural form bronchi. So this is what the normal structure. And then ultimately the air which is taken through the nasal cavity, passing through the pharynx, larynx, and then trachea, reaching to our lungs. And the lungs are made up of small tiny bulbous structures which are called alveoles. So very tiny structures. So there only the complete air is shifted, and each and every alveole which are present in our alveoli, plural form alveole singular, and each and every alveole here is filled with this oxygen, and then they are surrounded by lots of blood vessels, very tiny blood vessels. These tiny blood vessels will take the oxygen and then they give off the carbon dioxide. Again the alveoles, they take the carbon dioxide and flow back in the expiration, means when we release out, exhalation. By the time what happens from alveoles to different structures and then come to bronchi, bronchi to trachea, trachea to larynx, larynx to pharynx, pharynx to nasal cavity, and then releasing out. This is what normally happening, and this is a simple explanation on the diagram given. Let's see the process. This is another diagram which is actually given in your text. So this is the diagram given in text, but I felt this structure is a bit confusing one. That is why I have put forward. The another diagram, where is it? Yeah, this diagram I have given, and it will be simpler. Okay, so you go for this instead of this. Now what is happening? Respiratory passage, just I just orally explained you. You might have had some confusion also. Now you see the oxygen, look at the flow chart and then see oxygen comes in the arrow source to the nostrils, nostrils to nasal passage, then pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchi, bronchi means that division, bronchi, bronchioles, fine structures you can see in the diagram, small bronchi further get divided into small fractions like branches of a tree, right? So they are called bronchioles, and bronchioles to alveolar sacs, alveoles, and from the alveoles tissues through blood oxygen is given. And this supply of oxygen rich air from nostrils to alveoli. This is what happening in our inhalation. When we exhale, what happens here? It is just backflow. From the tissues, carbon dioxide is collected, taken to alveolar sacs, and alveoles supply it to bronchioles, bronchioles to bronchi, bronchi to trachea, trachea to larynx, larynx to pharynx, pharynx to nasal passage, nasal passage to nostrils, then released out. Where? Into the atmosphere. So this is what the process. Yellow, green, go through there. Yellow, green. But in these fractions of seconds, very less time we take, in that all these process taking place, yes, all these things are taking place. That is the beauty of our respiratory system. So this is called what? Respiratory passage. Very important structure. You may not find it anywhere, so you note it down nicely and then have a practice of it. If you mention, put this flow chart there in your examination, if the question comes, I assure you are going to get full marks. Now how that exchange of gases, nothing but respiratory process taking place, just already I have explained with the help of diagram, with the help of flow chart, the same thing in words. It is notes. Okay, simple notes, and these notes you can take it down. Once again I will explain you. Okay, so the air with the oxygen which is inhaled through nostrils, and the oxygen enters into nasal chamber and pharynx. Nasal chamber is nothing but nasal passage, then pharynx is commonly opening for respiratory as well as digestive tracts. It's a opening here, no, that box I told you, no, so that is a common open for respiratory tract as well as digestive tract. And here how it is getting differentiated or separated, suppose we inhale, the air goes to the lungs, but when you take food and swallow, it goes to stomach. How does it take place? It's because of a special structure called the epiglottis. What is epiglottis? Say that pharynx is like this, in that a flip like structure like this. So I think it is visible now, like this flip. When we go for inhalation, it is open. Okay, it is open. So the air penetrates through here, goes to lungs. When we go for swallowing, it goes for closing. You swallow something, swallow your saliva or take a gobble of water and swallow, by the time you can get here some tight feel, right? That tight feel is because of epiglottis goes and closes the pharynx. And when respiration, we don't feel that tightness, no tightness. But when it covers, when we go for food, taking food or swallowing food, it covers, then that tightness comes. Again, you swallow saliva. Saliva is rich in salivary amylase and then very important salts and all present. So swallowing saliva is a good habit, okay? Don't go for spitting everywhere. That is a very bad habit, because saliva is good. Only plum, when you are suffering from cough and cold, then you can spit it out there in the spittoons. That's different. But normally, spitting saliva is a bad habit. Those fellows or those children will generally have problems in digestion. okay, because this is full of digestive juices, so we have to swallow. So swallow once. While swallowing, you feel here tightness, it is because of epiglottis. So further to proceed, now when we take in the air goes there into the lungs, and then oxygen enters into trachea through larynx from the pharynx, and then oxygen further makes an entry into the primary bronchi, that lung lobes, right, and then further into alveoles, and ultimately to the alveoles wherein utilization taking place. So its flow is inhalation, nostrils to alveoles, exhalation, alveoles to nostrils. Respiratory passage is the best reference you can have. So this is what the respiratory process taking place in our body. Okay, so what we have discussed in this so far, we have discussed about definition of respiration, types of respiration, two different types basically, aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. How are they different from each other? Differences also mainly meant to for your exam point of view, as well as entrance test point of view, preparation, entrance test preparation point of view. Then respiration in human beings, respiratory tract, respiratory passage, and the respiratory process. So these are what so far we have discussed in this particular class. So once again, prepare well and then.